Plane geometry deals with the construction of plane curves such as ellipse, parabola, hyperbola, cycloid, involute, etc. So in that category, conic section, so the general theory of the conic section is nothing but a right circular cone resting on ground on its base is cut by cutting planes at different angles. So based on the cutting position of the angles, we can categorize the types of shapes. In first category, when the cutting plane is perpendicular to the axis of the cone, the curve of intersection obtained is a circle. In second category, when the cutting plane is passing through the apex and the base of the cone, the curve of intersection obtained is an isosceles triangle. In third category, when the cutting plane is inclined to the axis of the cone, the curve of intersection obtained is an ellipse. Fourth category, when the cutting plane is inclined to the axis of the cone and parallel to a generator, the curve of intersection obtained is a parabola. Last one, when the cutting plane is inclined at a very small angle with the axis or parallel to the axis, the curve of intersection obtained is a hyperbola. In second picture, you can see the different shape of the conic curves, parabola and hyperbola, and also ellipse. The main important thing is eccentricity. So eccentricity plays a vital role for constructing the conic sections. The general definition of eccentricity is nothing but distance of the moving point from the focus to the distance of the moving point from the directrix. So based on the location of the vertex point, we can categorize ellipse, parabola, hyperbola. If the eccentricity value is less than 1, it comes under the ellipse. When the eccentricity value is equal to 1, it is denoted as parabola. When the eccentricity value is greater than 1, it is denoted as hyperbola. So this is a general introduction of conics.
So good morning. So today we are going to discuss about the parabola under the plane curve topics. So I am going to discuss about the problem number 5. So problem number 5, the focus of your conic is 50 mm from the directrix. Draw the locus of a point P moving in such a way that its distance from the directrix is equal to the distance from the focus. Name the curve. Draw a tangent to the curve at a point 60 mm from the directrix. So it is an university question. It is asked in the 2014. So once again, repeat the problem at a particular sentence. Whenever you see the distance from the directrix is equal to the distance from the focus, so that means it indicates the parabola. That means eccentricity value is equal. So we know the eccentricity definition. So distance from the focus to vertex then distance from the vertex to center point, this ratio should be 1. If the ratio is 1, so it comes under the parabola. If the ratio is more than 1, it comes under the hyperbola. If the ratio is less than 1, it comes under the ellipse. So now it is equal distance, so it follows the parabola curve. So we can write the answer for the name of the curve is parabola. So now I can start the procedure. So as usual, same procedure as we have followed in the ellipse and also hyperbola. First of all, we need to construct the vertical straight line named as directrix. So DD dash the directrix. So in the directrix, from the center point of the directrix point C, we need to construct a horizontal axis. Horizontal line indicates the axis. So from the point C, the given value is 50 mm. So for the focus of a conic is 50 mm from the directrix. So from the point C, mark the point F at a 50 mm distance. So here 0 up to 50 mm. So I can mark the point here. I can name it as F. So due to the equal ratio, I can divide this line into two equal parts. So exactly, I need to mark vertex point B at 25 mm distance from the directrix. So it is a 25 mm distance. So I can mark it as V, vertex. So from the vertex I need to draw a vertical line like this. After that, measure the distance VF and transfer the distance VF to the vertical line like VG. After that, draw a boundary line through the point C to G by using 2H pencil like this. So now from the point V, that means vertex, mark the equal distance point. So always I am taking 10 millimeter equal distance. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 point is more than enough to construct a hyperbola. So I can mark 1 here, 2 here, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6. Now I can keep the minute after scale like this. That means parallel to VG. Then move the minute after scale through the point 1. Draw a vertical line above the axis, below the axis. Similar way through point 2, point 3, point 4, point 5, point 6. Now I can mark the boundary point as 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 1. Now listen carefully. For constructing a parabola curve, so measure the distance 1, 1, measure the distance 1, 1, and keep F as a center. Draw an arc above the axis and below the axis. Same way, measure the distance 2, 2, 1. Keep F as a center. Construct the above the arc and below the arc. Same way, point 3. Measure the 3, 3, 1 distance. F as a center. Cut an arc above the axis and below the axis through the point 3. Same way, 4, 4, 1. Measure 4, 4, 1 and F as a center. Cut an arc over the 4 above the axis and below the axis. And 5, 5. Measure 5, 5, 1. F as a center. Cut an arc above the axis and below the axis. Same way. 6, 6, 1, F as a center, cut an arc above the axis and below the axis. Now I mark the point, this is P1, P2, P3, P4. So we can mark the point P1, P2, P3. P4, P5, P6, P7, P8, P9, P10, 11, 12. So above the axis 6 points, below the axis 6 points. Totally 12 points we are getting. Now we can connect the curve. So using the French curve. So now I am getting 3, 4 consecutive points. So here 1, 2, 3. So I just join the curve. After that, 3, 4, 5, 6. same way bottom also. So in below the curve I can mark it here like this. And so maximum possible points we can match. Okay. So this is the parabolic curve. So I can extend like this. So this is the parabola. Now next step is construction of tangent and normal. In problem itself they have given some numerical values. Draw a tangent to the curve at a point 60 millimeter from the directrix. So once again I repeat the word, from the directrix I need to mark the point P with 60 millimeter distance. So this is the directrix. So from the directrix, I can mark 60 millimeter distance here. So from the 60 millimeter I just extend the vertical line over the curve. So this point is P. So this point is P. For locating this point P, they have given us 60 millimeter distance from the directrix. So now we can connect the point P to the point F. So once you connect the point P and F and keep the minute after scale parallel to point PF and draw a vertical line up to the directrix. Now I can mark the point as M. So now just to match the point M and P, draw a tangent line from M to B. So this is the tangent line. Again keep the minute after scale as it is, then move the minute after scale at the point P, draw a vertical line through the point P. So this is N. So PN normal, PT tangent. So now I need to mark the basic dimensions. So the distance between the directrix to focus value is 50. So just to project the focus value below here. So I can give the dimension here. So this is the distance between directrix to focus distance. Next we need to mark the location of point P. That is also given in the problem. So this is ...60 millimeter. So this is the structure of the parabola curve. Thank you.